Alright, hello once again YouTube. Welcome to my third attempt at trying to record this. Welcome to our Olympic tour round for the Doomed Originals tournament. You'll be finding these things. These are the so-called Olympics. Rather than finding any deliberate opposing competitor, your goal will be thus. These things are full of harpoons. You've got to try and not be destroyed for as long as possible. You can either survive to the end of the 10-minute time limit, destroy as many of these as possible, you'll have a much higher chance of winning. I'm going to count it as, basically, if you could destroy all of them, that'll put you in the very top category with the highest chance to win. If you could destroy at least some of them, you'll be above anyone below that hasn't destroyed all of them, or more than you. If you can't destroy any of them, but you lost the end of the time limit, that's the next sort of grade down. And then the bottom grade will be just survive as long as possible. So try to do as much damage as you can, but these things are quite heavily armoured and have four large harpoons each, which have pretty good endurance and long reach cables. So this goes. I've disabled the altitude limiter for this round because it disqualifies the limpets, but you've got to survive as long as possible. They don't have any extra damage causing equipment in them, but I believe missiles have some impact damage anyway. You will also take some damage from being harpooned. The limpets are not indestructible, but they are very durable. They're using the same chassis as the targets we've used in the previous tournament. Looks like the ice cream gang has been dragged down at around the 30-second mark, but has damaged one of the limpets. Possibly by causing collisions, by the looks of what's happening here. If it does come down to you survive the 10 minutes, I will grade it on percentage. Who gets the next position up, and I'll be awarding... I don't know quite how I'm going to do the points on this. I'll work something else out later. It might be that you get multiple points, or more points the higher up you are. Could be a good opportunity to come back. I'll probably do it something like 3 points for the winner, and then 2 for second and 1 for third. A good opportunity to score a few points, rounds worth of points here. Looks like, however, they have already dragged one to the ground and destroyed it. Oh no, maybe not destroyed. It is damaged, though. Oof. Sumo slammed that one into the ground. Those who do not know, Rododex's ground, as you can probably see from the damage happening here, is not very forgiving. The ice cream gang looks okay, but that's because it is mostly decoed. The actual internal structure, I can tell you from that much, is not doing great. Additionally, I believe the limpets, yes, they have self-repair systems. So if you cannot damage them fast enough, they will just come back. Competitors, I do not believe, are allowed these. Or if they were, they're only allowed a very minimal amount. Off the top of my head. Except they are primarily focusing on the core, which is probably a good idea. They've sort of got it a bit pinned in at this point. As for what this is supposed to be a test of, it's mostly your ability to, like, cope with essentially harpoon builds or manipulating. How well can you survive opponent trying to throw you around? How strong are your thrusters? How good's your ability to cope from being disoriented? Reasonably good, I would say, from what we've seen so far. Yes, as for these harpoons, they are large missiles with two fins, prediction guidance, and four cables on each. And remember, these targets are made of heavy armor, so they're very heavy. They're probably heavier than any of the competitors. Does that mean they can pull all of them down? We shall see. Ice Cream Gang kind of has a bit of a unique opportunity here, in that it is three craft, not one. However, this does mean each one is lighter individually. It looks like that. Yeah, the smaller ones could just about pull that weight. The limpets do take damage occasionally when they crash into each other, but they're pretty resilient. That shouldn't knock any of them out. I'll be going by team health for the overall health, though, for how much damage is taken. So at the moment, I'm freaking down to 81%. Ooh, one's getting focused a little more now. Yeah, they actually look to have enough thrust that they can... Oh, they can kind of get around it a bit, but they're going to smash into each other now. And yes, they're still going to pull down to ground level. They get pulled into each other, that, right? Was that collision avoidance, or did they just get lucky? Either way, they're definitely all been webbed up. I'll be doing every single craft individually for this one. I might have to cut some for time and do a second recording of this, depending on how this goes, because I have about an hour and a half to record. I might split this one at the half-hour mark anyway for each round, because it might be a bit of a long round since it's all individual and I'm only getting through one at a time. And we've got about 13 entries. 11 entries? I can't remember exactly, but we've got quite a lot, so Yeah, I'll probably split this at roughly the halfway mark, so maybe every three fights or so, depending on how long they go for. They were doing reasonably okay, but they do seem to be getting properly wedged in now. The limpets seem to have a good hold on them. They are firing back, there is damage happening, but they're not able to outpace the self-repair by the look of it. And they might not be able to. I didn't necessarily design this match to be fair, I designed it to be interesting. But they're able to do a bit of damage. So I think they've knocked out the harpoons on one of them, but it's coming back quite quickly. So two of those have been slammed together again. Oh, that's doing them no good at all. They're getting ground into each other. Oh, AI dead. Oh, he has killed one target. Congratulations, that might put you in the lead. Well, it's definitely put you in the lead for now, because there's only one competitor so far. Will you get more than that? Don't know. They are still very much pinned in. Yeah, still getting a chance to volley off occasionally. Given the damage they haven't been doing, I can only assume that a collision opened up the back section. Oh yeah, look at the armor inside that thing. Very much volume saving armor. Not sure that matters much in melee though. Or collisions anyway. So I don't know whether this match will benefit faster moving ones or faster moving machines or sturdier ones, because the sturdier ones tend to be quite massive. Warden and the Shiploten, for example, are pretty huge. They'd be very vulnerable to getting targeted. Teams on 65%, I suppose that won't matter because their grade at the moment is one target destroyed. I was saying earlier a little better, so we'll go, you'll be scored in rank of like, killed all of them, we'll be at the very top, and then it'll be in time for the fastest if there's a draw. Then it will be killed the most, highest percentage is there, health remaining if there's a draw. Then it will be health remaining, not destroyed, and then it will be destroyed. Well, destroyed will be the longest time, rather, the longest time to get knocked out. Looks like Ant's going to survive destruction, even though they are being sumo slammed into each other in. It's not doing that one any good. But look how many blocks are in it for how small it is. Maybe I should have put some loads of filler in these harpoons. Yeah, that one's engine, that one's propellers are still running, but all it seems to be able to do is keep itself off the ground, and that's about it. Of course, Crino Send, they are full of hydrogen. Oh, we have a dead. That's bad news, that means the rest are going to get focused on. That propeller avoided smashing itself on the floor. Is it just cosmetic? Just from the Vex collisions being a bit weird. I've seen this thing take hits in the previous round and just survive it. Maybe you can make it visually a lot harder than it is. Ooh. It's paused. Why is it paused? It has dead? What happened? Oh, no, it actually paused for me there. Why did it pause? It ain't done yet. Small one's getting dragged down now. The thing is, of course, they've ended up a bit stopped, so it might just be that that one just ends up tied up down there. Just gradually getting more and more harpooned. Oh. Use some harpoons, or did they just wear it? No, maybe just wore off. Oh, that one has come free. Could it be destroyed a second target? We shall see. At least they've thrown its missile launches anyway. This might be big though, because this might get this one moving. This might mean if it does get grabbed again, something actually happens. I'm going to put rockets in its direction, but it's getting further and further away. I'll give them credit, they're still fighting. It's reactivated. Harpoon incoming. And this could be big, because it's going to start dragging it in a different direction. That might mean it goes down. And the other harpoons are mostly become stuck. Yep, there we go. Looks like they tighten, it'll pull close from close to the ground level. And it's got the others moving a little bit as well. Yes, that's a bit more like it. It's so stuck. And it might take collision damage with the floor. It looks like it's resting on missiles. It can't seem to get enough speed up to do any more damage to it. Looks like it's going to be one target and survive for Amphrix's score. Alright, I will mark that down. One target. Lived. On 46%. Should have checked that the moment the map ended, but anyver. Next the better though. Looks like we're gonna have to split these into bits and do this round in pieces. It's going down the list one at a time, so it'll be Amp's other ship, the ship floating. And it's a goal. Okay. This is going to be interesting because it's got more firepower, but it's a single craft and it's huge. I cannot foresee it evading any of these. It is probably about to take five harpoons. Oh, it is attempting to shoot them down. It has got one. Because we're not normally allowed big missiles in this round, so none of the seaways will be built to defeat them. Alright, Bowser's Castle. How are you looking? He is being dragged downwards. What is it? It's just being kept in the air. Might be that it has enough lift to resist these. Let's say, but it is still getting dragged downwards. And there are more harpoons. I'm fairly strong, but I think every single missile is now... Yeah, it's now been latched by literally every shot apart from that one. I think it just flew through a hole or something. Might have gone straight through that middle section. There are some very pretty crafts in this tournament. The aesthetics have definitely been on point for everyone. As predicted, it's actually dodging some, but I think that's more because of its erratic movement than because it's actually agile enough to dodge anything. Okay, well, it looks like it's nosing down. Has it sustained some damage to the front, or is this just the way it's been cabled? And I drag it down over a hill. That's actually a really good place to get it if they can. Because that will put it in a vulnerable spot. It is firing back. It has not necessarily managed to do its damage, though. Write down the scores on there. We'll post it. Open the text document so we'll find out what the round scores are in the next round, not this one. We'll make sure to update them straight away once this one's over. Yeah, it looks like they're just hanging there for now. It's got a stick in them. Getting grappled from all sides though, definitely. That's a good thumbnail, right? Some giant spider attack. That's what I can have a mine on. You're about to hop on yourself. No. Come one. Attempt two. Can you drag it down yet? It does seem to have a lot of lift. It seems to be able to resist being dragged, although not enough to actually lift the target. Just enough to not be dragged around. That might be more thrust than lift at this point. I think it is the physically largest craft in the tournament, or at least one of them anyway. Said these missiles are clearly doing some damage. They are punching holes in it. It will lose buoyancy the more hit it, and they're not missing. Punch the holes through those sections. They're no longer buoyant. Looks like its rear propeller is helping a little bit. That's just the board working hard. Is it going to destroy a target? One of those is pretty badly damaged. Doesn't look like it. Maybe I should have ACB'd this so it would drop harpoons after a minute so they keep refreshing. Well, I think it just shot itself there. Does have plasma, which is not something I believe any of the other competitors have. Might help it against the heavy armor, I'm not sure, but they are repairing. Managed to get itself upright again, but it actually seems to have lost lift doing this, if anything. I think the way they're moving, they're trying to drag it in a circle. I think at the moment, if this keeps up, it's actually going to score worse, because it won't have managed to destroy any of them, even though it's avoided damage. It'll just be survived, no damage caused. It. So you take advantage of its bad angle to rotate that one. Switch to the other? No. These two are being damaged or being dragged along by it. That does count. Yeah, at the moment, it seems to be unsteady. Seems to have, like, found a spot in between them. Oh. Is it going downwards? No, they're trying that. Might do well in the later rounds. There is a lifting round later on. Yeah, it looks like they're all stuck to it. It can't really, Oh, hello. Say that, but the limpets are trying something else. They're going to try and roll it, I think, with that maneuver. If it gets caught out by that, they're just going to flip over if that cables so many tensions. There it goes, I think. Yeah, they're pulling tight. Are they going to be able to roll it? No, it's pulling back again. Oh, it's bludging those three together. Could be an opportunity for a kill hit. Which way is it firing? It is pointing its guns in that direction, but they're not firing. No, they are a little bit. This might be an opportunity to destroy a target. Can you do it? The sword scoff ramp. Two of his creations have managed to get one out. There goes the cram. Another harpoon's been fired. And you punctured something important. I think it just ate that gun shell. Another hit. Oh, and that one seems to have had a big effect. That jolted down a fair bit doing that one. Targets are still repairing faster than they're taking damage at the moment. That's fine. You better hurry up. You're actually scoring worse than the ice cream gang at the moment. MC Wiz is trying, but it's just not doing anything here. Get another harpoon hit. Yeah, it looks like the harpoons don't do quite enough continuous damage to breach any, not enough to breach a significant number of its buoyancy chambers to drop it, but it also doesn't really seem to be able to do enough damage, even dragging the others around, to actually take one out. So yeah, not good. You've got to be able to kill one to actually score in this round. Another blow to the underside. That's probably another ballast chamber breached. Doesn't seem to be affecting it that much. It's very lifty. Now we wait. Relaxing around in some strange ways. Drifting over that there hill. Probably got to tension that off a little bit by that one that's moving over there. Also probably a good thing that cables don't get tangled in jet. And for those lift jets, they better be pits jets working out there. They might be working as lift jets and then. Oh, hello. Oh, it's getting nose down again. I think the pit jets are trying to resist it being pulled down. It paused again. Why did it pause at 13 1 minute thingy again? No idea. That was the same time, I think. They're kind of pulling in one direction. Are they going to try all pulling in one direction at once? That might do something. I'm also interested to see what some of the faster ships in the tournament do, because the slower ones have pretty universally been caught. I've only seen two. The Aspen Ganger will not classify as an especially fast one, so I think it's fair to say the slower one so far. I'm also going to destroy a target at the last moment. That's pretty bad damage there. Yes, no, maybe not. Or is it going to get dragged over? No, they are working real hard to try and pull it over, but those thrusters on the bottom, they're giving it enough power to resist. Well, that might have been the ammo going out in one of the harpoon vehicles. Yeah, I think the ammo just went out in that target. The missile system, rather. That said, they finally managed to drag it down at the last second. Question, actually, have they? Or is it going to pull back again? Yeah, it's resisting at the last minute. Yeah, breaking the harpoons actually sometimes breaks the stalemate and means they actually can pull you again. I think it's going to survive, but it's going to be a worse score. It looks like it's going to be one target, 95.6%. No, zero target. Okay. On to the last one for this round. These have been long ones. Right. So I'm doing these ones in order, so Arthur's Shifotan is now the Evil Eye, it's me. I don't have a good feeling about this one because I've seen how my thing handles against these. It gets port. Unless it's quick. Right. That said, is equipped with EMP, which will do some damage against heavy. I don't know how much. And it is quick compared to some of the competitors. Not the fastest, but it's not the slowest either. Will it still get caught, however? Pretty quickly by the look of it. I've not designed these turrets to be particularly weak to EMP. In fact, they're fairly weak against everything. Fairly thick armor. It's got caught pretty quickly. I don't like the looks of this. No, it killed one! They are at least somewhat vulnerable to EMP then. Oh, it's killed two, three? Yo, okay. Oh! Okay, full kill, 39 seconds. I guess we could do another round. Evil. Full. S, and then 96.3%. Not gonna lie, I thought with that much, I thought with that much heavy armor, I thought heavy armor would eat EMP. Maybe I should have put some EMP proofing. Well, next round. I'm going to be my only point for this tournament. Right. Night Rocker. Let's go. Can you put in as good a performance? But yes, to show it off, so I'm not lying here. The AI is in the back. It is surrounded by heavy armor. It is connected to it, but I was under the impression heavy armor absorbed the MP and took damage itself rather than letting it through. I could be wrong. It might just have overwhelmed it. Night Rocker. The boat. So it does. Not the most stable, but that might be helpful here for evading shots. Its firepower is alright, as is its survivability. We've seen that. Is that Cramwiz? That looked like Cramwiz as well. It's at least having a Sea Wiz attempt. Yeah, it's definitely got seaweeds. It's trying to shoot out the harpoons. It's done good damage to that limpet. 1 to 94%. Seems to be holding up alright. But the targets are still moving. Still getting harpoons established. It has dodged a few more than some of the others. Dodged better than the evil eye, I would say. The evil eye's path is predictable, whereas this thing's is not. That said it is... No, I think it's alright. Will this be good for it? If it can avoid missiles, it won't get bound up, but that might be bad. It might just mean it's not scoring. As I said, these targets aren't invincible. Apparently very much so when it comes to EMP. I genuinely thought they'd resist it, but... Not durable either. Not feeble either, I should say. Oh, it's been dragged upside down. That's not good. It's going to hit the ground. Okay, the Night Rock has been dragged into the floor, upside down. Looks like it might be stuck now. Not taking much collision damage, though. It did not take too much of a bump. It has lost a lift thruster, at least on one side. Still trying to give it that rocking behaviour, which is probably intentional, given the name. It's lifting up, but it's getting absolutely volleyed by harpoons. They're probably going to drag it down again with that many sticking to it. Said it is dodging, alright. You going to break another propeller? No, not quite, but they did break something. Rangefinder took a bump. It's possible that some people have fitted theirs with rubber, and if they have, props to you. You'll be alright here, but there it goes. At least you won't die anyway. A lot harder than this floating by the look of it. That evasive behaviour is helping it, but it's still getting stuck by most of them. Yeah, looks like it might be bound down now. I think it's going to struggle to get away. These are genuinely probably working the campaign, I'm starting to realise as well. Put a bit of EMP proofing on them. Let's watch them like snag everything, especially, well, I was going to say Ashes of the Empire, but they're too big for the volume limit. If you did volume limitless Ashes, you could probably just deploy these and just snag everyone's tanks. Yeah, if you mounted these on a swim chassis, you could probably use these. Put some spikes to them. You can actually drag things in. Yeah, it's firing at them, but... Doesn't look like it has the damage. Might be the angle it's stuck at. It looks like it can't get any main guns to bear. Kind of a really awkward spot to get stuck, because it's on the hill, it can't really... Yeah, it's on the hill, it's angled down, but the targets are over there. The little roof guns are still trying. So I don't think they're going to get much done like that, though. Drop a bonk with that one. I think it's just kind of stuck. We'll see if it can get itself through it free, but... So it looks like all the cable guys are about to pull tight here. This is where you'd, if you're playing neater, this is absolutely where you'd just go and board the ship at this point. Well, perfectly safe, but... Yeah, maybe that'd be what it'd be good for, like a pirate campaign. Tie down the foe and then board them, so they can't move. Is it taking damage when it hits the ground? No, it's not hitting it hard enough. Being gently bumped over and over again. Whether I need some kind of immobilization or for just not dead, but you're just completely stuck. I might even put that in. I'll say 2 minutes of being completely bound, stuck, and we'll not have lost. So I'll say 3 minutes 22. Not that I don't want to give it the benefit of the full time limit, but we don't want to be sat here forever. If it's clear that it can't do anything to break out, we might as well wrap up. I'll still count it as a damage taken, because nothing's going to change, but I'll do that as an extra clause to wrap up the fight a little early if it can't break through and it's clearly bound in place. Thank you. Okay, it's a minute through its disqualification thing timer. It's the 320, it is out. It just seems to be stuck. Okay, maybe we did allow some small self-repair because it is gradually recovering health. I think it's recovered 0.3 of HP though. Could have just lost 0.3 and I'm reading it wrong. Yeah, I think it's really stuck. I don't think it's going to break free. Oh, hello. Say that. Then it... oh, nothing. It does nothing. It did zero damage. Oh yeah, those who haven't seen. It's got a little stage in the back. Night Rocker thing is accurate. It does actually have a little concert going on back there. That said, it's been called early. That is the Night Rocker out. I'm going to call that there. So, Night Rock, and it was 95. So, zero target. 95.1% that was on. Slightly below Amphreet, unfortunately, on that one. It didn't last quite as long. Right, we'll call the first recording there. I'll split this one up into three, and I'll join you again in part two.